In this video, we're going to talk about some of the special features of Microsoft Office drawing objects. We're going to talk about WordArt objects. We're going to talk about SmartArt objects. We're going to talk about the special effects that can be used to manipulate raster and vector graphics. I'm going to start with a blank slide, and I'm going to insert a text box. I'm going to select my text box, and then I'm going to go to Drawing Tools, Format, and I have a number of options here for WordArt. And as I look at these different options, what it does is it dramatically changes my text. I can click on the drop-down, and I can see some pretty interesting looking options that are available here. So I'm going to select one of these. Another thing I can do to WordArt, which will affect my fonts, is I can do a variety of text effects. I can add a reflection. I could add a rotation. I can do a transformation and have the text appear to move along a path or to move like a wave. Once I've created the word art, I can edit my text, make changes to it. I can increase my font size, just as if it's normal text. So as you can see, there's a lot of different possibilities here. Besides WordArt, I can add what are called SmartArt objects. SmartArt objects are graphics that allow me to visually communicate an idea, such as a collection of items, or a linear process, a cycle, hierarchy, certain kinds of relationships, such as counterforces or interlocking concepts. I'm going to create a cycle, and I'm going to select one of these cycles, and I'm going to click on OK. Just click in each of these boxes to enter my text. But notice that I have one too many objects. What I can do is I can select one of the objects and hit the delete key on my keyboard, and it automatically removes the related arrow. If I wanted to add more items, I could click on shape and it would add more items to the graphic. There's a number of different layouts I can use. I can choose different graphical styles. I can select different colors. So there's a number of opportunities here for different things I can do. I can use a shape. Some of these shapes I can use have a arrow integral to it, and then I can select my shape and just begin typing into it. I can increase the size of my shape. I can change the style of my shape. Let's say that I want to create my own visualization to express an idea. When you visit a website, there's a possibility that the website might consist of multiple frames. Right-click on one of these frames, you can see the frame by itself. And these are actually miniature web pages within web pages. Let's say I'm trying to explain this idea through a slide. I'll take a screenshot of my current screen, and I want to only get the window and not get the taskbar. So I'll hold down the Alt key and press Print Screen. When I go back to PowerPoint, I will create a new slide, remove the placeholders from the slide, and I'm going to right-click and paste my screenshot. I can size down my screenshot. And what I want to do is I want to call attention to the parts of the screen that are frames. So I'm going to draw a box around each of these frames. I can take this box and I can change the fill style. I can change the shape outline. Instead of having to find the exact color that I used before, I can use the Format Painter. When I move to the Clipboard Control Group and the Home Ribbon, I look for the little paintbrush. That's the Format Painter. I can click on the Format Painter when I have something selected, and then I'm going to click on my blue box so it takes on that formatting style. And as you can see, that's much easier than changing the outline and changing the fill to exactly what I wanted. If I selected all of these objects and resized them, you'll notice that they resize and they lose their positioning. So this isn't what I want. So I will go up to the Undo button and press Undo. And what I can do is I can group these objects. And now when I resize, you will notice that they keep their position when I resize them. If I hold down the Shift key, when I resize, no matter where I move the mouse, it will stay with the correct aspect ratio and will not become distorted. I can apply effects to these objects by going up to the Picture Tools Format ribbon and going to Picture Effects. I can go to the Adjust Control Group and change the color of my image. I can change the brightness or the contrast. I'm going to go to the Picture Effects menu under Picture Tools Format, and I'm going to choose one of the presets. And I'm going to select this preset right here. As you can see, it laid out my graphic, but if I did not like the way this was presented, I can change these options. Let's say I want to take one of these frames and show the frame moving away from the source web page as a three-dimensional object. Since I still have it in my clipboard, I can paste in my original graphic and then use the crop function to grab only the part of my image that I am interested in. I can then apply a 3D effect to my graphic. I can create my own custom 3D effect, applying a specific X, Y, and Z that I might want. And as you can see, I've created a 3D effect, making it look like this frame is coming out of the page. Now granted, I could spend a lot more time adjusting this and making it look specifically how I want it to look. I can go to the Shapes and create a text box. I can change the style on a text box. I can insert an arrow, drawing attention to what I want to discuss. I can attach the arrow to the text box. So if I move the text box, the arrow will move with it. As you can see, the graphics capability of PowerPoint are quite flexible.